Shalom, my name is Raha Ernest, and we have been looking into those scriptures which will make a huge difference in your life, scriptures that can turn your life around. And we started Psalm 121 some days ago, and now we are in verse 7, and this is what it says: "The Lord shall preserve you from all evil." That means there's none that's evil out there that God will not keep you from. I mean, God has died for the sins of the world, that he might redeem you, he said, from this present evil world. So God knows the world is evil, and he's promised to preserve you, to keep you safe from any future destruction. You know, preservation here kind of works in threefold, because you are three-part being. You know, 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 23 says, "And the very God of peace sanctify you wholly." And he said, "I pray God, your whole spirit and soul and body be preserved blameless." And if you've given your life to Jesus, you are preserved from eternal damnation, eternity in hell. That's the first priority God has given you. Your spirit is saved, and your soul can be saved if you allow God to transform your heart, transform your mind, because your soul is your emotions, your will, and your mind. Romans 12 verse 2 says, "Be transformed by the renewing of your mind." That means when you choose to allow the word of God to renew your mind, your soul, your heart will be preserved from destruction that's in the world, and your body can benefit from that. You cannot fight for your body to be preserved if your soul is not transformed and if your spirit is not saved from eternal damnation. That would be like putting the cart before the horse. So what has happened, what Jesus did, he has saved your spirit, made a way for your spirit to be saved. He's made a way for through his word and through ministry of his Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit of God, he's made a way for your soul to be transformed. And as a result, your body will be saved. So it's Psalm 121 verse 7. That's the scripture for today.